In today's video, we got a new lake to complain about, some leaks from Nvidia, and way too many cameras. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Before we start, let me just give a big thanks to our sponsor who makes these videos possible, Memory Express. They're based here in Canada and offer a complete price beat guarantee, not to mention their stores, which are a great place to try out all of the newest peripherals for yourself before you buy them. Check out their online shop in the link down below. All right, let's get started. Broadwell, Skylake, KB Lake, Coffee Lake, the Coffee Lake Refresh, and Cascade Lake. What do they all have in common? Well, they're all 14 nanometer processors, of course. This has been going on for the last 4 years, and apparently it's not over. That's right, apparently Intel is not done adding pluses to their 14 nanometer line because a new architecture dubbed Comet Lake S is rumored to make an appearance next year. According to the reports, this family of CPUs will have a 10-core 20-thread variant as its flagship. I mean, I'm all for adding cores to CPUs, but the problem here is that Intel has squeezed so much out of their 14 nanometers that I highly doubt that we would see any improvements between a Coffee Lake core and a Comet Lake core. If this rumor is true, then we might see the 10 nanometers chip appear first on the high-end desktop platform, similar to how Broadwell got 14 nanometer chips first in 2014. My real problem on the other end with Intel is their pricing scheme. Why can't they just give us whatever is new at the same price as the flagship the year before? Nvidia did it for years, excluding RTX, and they kept improving rather than rehashing the same process node. Anyways, I honestly hope they figure out their 10 nanometer line, or my prediction is that AMD will beat Intel at core clocks and IPC by 2020. Then we have some benchmarks on the much anticipated successor to the very popular GTX 1060. So the numbers come as usual from the Final Fantasy XV benchmark board. Why does every leak start with this benchmark? So far, all the leaks on this board have been accurate, and I'm surprised that they keep posting their scores on there. I mean, they're unreleased GPU, shouldn't you keep that a secret? Anyways, the successor to the 1060 is surprisingly dubbed the RTX 2060. We thought it would be GTX, but nope. If this card really has RTX features into it, then we're in for a world of trouble in my opinion. I mean, the only card that can run current ray tracing games at 1080p 60fps is the 2080 Ti. Try that on the 2060 and you might have to tune down to 480p to get anything near playable. The good news is that according to the benchmarks, it is 30% faster than the 1060. I know a lot of you guys were expecting the 2060 to beat the 1070, but we have to be real here. Nvidia could only do those big jumps in performance for so long before it sort of normalized. 30% still sounds fair to me, but the real question is the price. Will these be starting at $399? Or will we see the price of the 2060 closer to the predecessor's launch? Considering that it doesn't beat the 1070, I would probably expect a $299 price point, but the RTX features might bump the price up. What do you guys think? Let me know down below. In smartphone news, it seems like LG heard that Samsung wanted to add a few cameras to their flagship and decided to beat them to the punch. After the 6-camera S10 rumors, we got a 6-camera LG phone. Wait, what? 16 cameras? What in the? Of course, I'm just kidding. It's just a patent for now. And honestly, I hope it doesn't become real. 16 cameras means 16 lenses and 16 sensors, which means 32 new points of failure and a phone that would scare anyone who has trypophobia. The patent makes the module look pretty small, which could result in poor performance for all of the cameras. I mean, they could use one big sensor and then just crop it for each lens, but that would be way too innovative for what we have right now. The camera array could be used to create some cool images though. Something like this would be a fun feature, although it would probably get boring pretty fast, kind of like loops. You know, you play around with it for a few weeks and then you're done. What do you think of this 16 camera phone? Let me know down below, I'd love to hear it. Also, do you have trypophobia? Cause I do, and it creeps me out. Lastly, I'd like to know what you guys picked up for Black Friday. Were you like me and were looking for a good deal on storage? Did you pick up a new GPU or a new case, or did you go IKEA shopping like me and Eber? I'd love to know what you got. Just let me know down below. Don't forget to check out Memory Express's Cyber Monday sale. You might have a few hours after this video goes live. Anyways, that is pretty much it for the news. Guys, don't forget to let me know what you thought of today's stories down below. You can click right here to see the latest video and right here to subscribe to the channel. You know, it's free content and subscription. This is what we got right now. As usual, stay frosty and I'll see you on the next one. You know, I've really been into that song lately. You know, it goes something like,